People, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now today I'm going to talk about a topic that I find interesting, and I think some of you may agree. And that is the transformation of, I guess you could say, ordinary young men into what you can only describe as walking dopeies. I'm talking about seeing somebody who, when you look at their pictures, because they say a picture tells a thousand stories. When you look at their pictures from when they were young men or boys, and then you compare it to how they look right before they either lose them life or they're so hot that they're now topping most wanted lists, you can see the difference. You can see young men who have lost their humanity. I got the concept for this video. I'm speaking to one of my subscribers, a female subscriber that you know you are, big up yourself. She was telling me about Bigger Crime, because hopefully you would have seen my video on Delano Bigger Crime Williams, the video where I said he's one of the most vicious youths Jamaica has ever produced. Now she said to me, Bigger Crime, a fierce boy. She was saying, Serpy, in that picture there, him don't even look like a menace, right? She's saying, you know, he's a handsome youth, don't figure out like that. And then it dawned on me, you know what? A lot of the pictures we have of these 87s, these 90s, the pictures are not up to date. By that I mean, when the picture was taken, they were either very young and they had even though they might start bad already, they had some form of innocence left in them. Because the Bigger Crime picture, really, when you look at it, if you see that you walking on the road, you would never know. You would never know who and what Bigger Crime was capable of. Well, that's because the picture was outdated. The picture wasn't taken in the months and weeks leading up to his death. And the famous picture, the one that you're looking at your screen right now, Bigger Crime on the left, Eldon Calvert on the right. You would be mistaken to think these are just two normal youths. Eldon Calvert on the right. Again, this is another picture of him when he was young. As you can see, he's smiling. If you never see this youth on a most wanted list, you would never know that that was one of the leaders of Stonecrusher. If somebody just said to you, hey, look on them two pictures here, you would never know you're looking at two are the deadliest youths to come out of St. James. So now I'm going to show you an individual who perfectly summarized how young men transform into dopey. See, when you make enough dopeys, you eventually become one yourself. Who am I going to use? You will have seen the thumbnail. I'm going to use another Delano. But this Delano is Delano Wilmot, aka Preke Boy. But before I get to Preke Boy, I'm going to show you the individual on your screen right now. That is Kidon Johnson, aka Bad Fram. Now, a lot of Jamaicans might not know that name. You'd have heard me mention him a few times before. But Spanish Town people know that name. Maxfield Avenue people know that name. Bad Fram was one of the most vicious youth to come out of Klansman. Dangerous, dangerous youth. But as you can see, Bad Fram sits in between the kind of picture you'll see from Delano Williams and Eldon Calvert and the picture I'm going to show you of Preke Boy. See, Bad Fram is where you can start to notice the eyes. I've always told you, if you really want to know when somebody is transitioning towards darkness, check their eyes. They can shave all of the hair off of them face, they can get a haircut, but the one thing that doesn't lie, the one thing you can't hide, is the eyes. Now if you notice, Eldon Calvert, the young picture of Bigger Crime, they're not really there yet in those pictures. But Bad Fram, if you look in his eyes, you can see he's beginning to lose his humanity. Now, Bad Fram end up look even worse than this. By the time he lost his life, he looked closer to the menace that you're going to see, that is Preke Boy. But I don't have a picture apart from at that stage, right? But I'm just trying to show you the transition from young youth, smiling, almost, if you don't know who they are, innocent look, to in between, which is bad from, where they're starting to lose it. You can see it in their eyes. And now I'm going to show you the end result of an Apex 87 that has lost their humanity. I'm going to show you Preky Boy. Look at your screen right now. Three pictures put together, all the same man. Now the picture on the right, my longtime viewers and subscribers remember that picture. I think it's my most viewed video of all times. The exclusive photo of Preky Boy walking around his community with his M16 rifle. But that's the end result. Look at the far left. Then look in the middle. Then look at the right. It's almost as if a three different people you look at. You can more or less make out certain features. For example, his nose, right, his jawline in the first two pictures. But by the time he gets to the right, he looks like a complete different individual. See, on the left, apart from the gun resting in his lap, he must look like a normal youth, a normal young Jamaican youth sitting on the corner. I drink him one juice, sitting on a wall. If it wasn't for the gun, he probably wouldn't even think that youth is at 87, right? As you can see, you know, him face shave up, right? He might wanna look a hoodie on him head, yes, but, you know, like a normal youth. But the transition in the middle, you can start to see it in his eyes. Remind the people, him start bad from the left already, you know. But you don't lose it immediately. You don't start getting that look immediately. You don't just start getting those eyes after you make your first one or two doppy. It takes time. You have to become seasoned. It's a slow process. Preky Boy shows us this transition from start to finish. And it would be amazing if I could get an even younger picture of him. Like when he was like in his early teens, and then put that to the left. Then we could see the full transition. But nevertheless, the reason why I put the bad front picture, right, is because in the middle, you can see that Preky has that look similar to where bad from is coming from. Two of them have the same look. Where sure, in the face, they're not smiling or nothing, but it's the eyes. The eyes is the first thing to go. Preky Boy, bad from, you can see it in their eyes. But Preky Boy on the right almost seems to morph into somebody that looks a shadow of his former self. Look at the far left and look at the far right. Forget about even the beard, because yes, he has a beard and all that. You would think the person on the left is like 50 years younger than the person on the right. No. These pictures are not taken over 30 years, man. Preky Boy is still young. I don't know his exact age, but he's still young. He's wanted for him in his 20s. And he's not been wanted for 15, 20 years. Even on the right, that's a young man you're looking at. Preky Boy looks as if him can be somebody's great-grandfather. I've never seen anything like this. The transition is extraordinary. This is what badness does to people. You see the look on the right? You know why he looks like he's aged 50 years? That's what happened when you had many sleepless nights. That's what happened when you can't lay down in your bed and just have a sleep comfortably. This is what happened when you have a sleep with one eye open. When you're constantly anxious. When you're constantly thinking, is today my last day? This is what happens when you can't trust nobody. You don't want to go look for that Virginia, because that Virginia might be the person who will set you up. You can't just walk down the road to go buy this. You can't go buy that. It is very taxing. This is why, if you haven't heard my video on Cedric Doggy Murray, you need to go check it out, because Doggy explained fully what badness really is. It's not this fun thing you hear in a music. This is how I know your favorite entertainer don't know what I'm talking about. Sure, it might send somebody go mash a rocks here, and it might send somebody go shoot. But it's the people who actually do things. They know. badness, violence, it's not fun at all. It isn't fun. How many times do I have to say it? Seasoned soldiers hate war, seasoned bad man hate badness. Because this is what it does to you. On the right. All that fun and games, smiling and, you know, oh, you have 100 women after you. Yeah, that's at the start. That's at the start. You see, on the left, when Preke boy have him going on him lap and him out drinking one juice. Yeah, you see, that stage, sure, you have all the kerosene I hang around you and everybody want. You are the real man on the block. Because at that point, sure, you're hot, but you're not lava hot. You see, when it's hot and you can still walk on the block and you can go link a girl over here, someone, she can come meet you down the road and people want to be associated with you. Sure. That's on the left. Maybe in the middle. But you see, by the time you transform to the person on the right of your screen, at that point, nobody no one there on you. At that point, even your own mother don't even want there on you. Because she know, say, it's only a matter of time before JCF or JDF catch up on you. And even if you go link somebody, anything them give you, then gone right away. Them don't even want to hang around. If a food ain't come drop off you, as them put it in your hand, then gone. If a money, as soon as it's exchanged, then gone. Nobody know on their own. It's a lonely world. See, every time you kill somebody, you end up losing a piece of your own humanity. Let me say that again. Every time you kill somebody, you end up losing a piece of your own humanity. And if you kill enough people, if you do enough damage, if you rain down enough death and destruction, that is the end result on the right. You end up looking like Delano Wilmot, aka Preke Boy. You start to look as if you could be some kind of character in a sci-fi movie. I'm not even trying to be funny here. I'm not even trying to crack no joke. On the right, Preke Boy look like him could have gone in a Star Wars or one of them show there. He won't even if he apply no kind of makeup or put on no kind of costume, just walk into the set just like how him look there so. And he would fit into any Star Wars movie, any sci-fi movie. Preke Boy is on the verge. Too many sleepless nights, too much dopey dip on him, too much science, because everybody know Preke Boy is a big fan of phobia, he said it himself. The man, as he wake up, have to aisle up, have to rub down, science man make money off a Preke Boy. Now, of course, he would tell you that it's worth it because he's still around. And I have to say, it's extraordinary that he's still here. See, Preke Boy, every time they go for Preke Boy, they end up killing somebody else. Remember when they went for him and people said, yes, Preke Boy did. No, it was his Bridging Cruise. They end up taking a rifle off him, but it wasn't Preke Boy. So that only convinced Preke Boy, say, him science man strong. And that make him even spend more money and more money on the science. Well, Preke, we're going to see how much longer the science lasts. Because I know you believe in it strongly. And so far, you would tell anybody, I to keep you alive. Another dangerous 87 who was a big fan of the science was the youth from over St. Thomas called Dopey Flynn. Him loved the science. Him loved the aisle down and throw powder and all kind of things. And we all saw how his luck run out. Dopey Flynn used to even take trips to Haiti to get him special science. But time will tell. One thing we know about this 87 game, this badness game, this wanted man game, is that it's usually a matter of case of when, not if. And as I said in the video, the original video about Preke Boy showing him walking around, or showing the picture of him walking around with a rifle, I just cannot see police taking in Preke Boy and him going on a station to get put through a process and end up a jail. Preke Boy is very likely to go out in a gunfight. And to be honest, though the police them want him, no matter what happened, we're going to probably hear says a quote-unquote shootout. I just can't see them bringing in Preke Boy alive. He may have to go down on a station with his pastor, his JP, him granny, and Mother Lou for them spare him. And even with all them people down there, them probably still kill him. Preke Boy, hot like lava. Preke Boy challenged the JDF and the JCF to a gunfight. Preke Boy shoot up police vehicle. Freaky boy make the military up on the back foot. Trust me, when me tell you say them want this youth head, them want it. So it seems as if he's made up his mind that there's not going to be any kind of handing over and no kind of jail time. It seems like he make up his mind say it's just going to be a shootout to the end. Hence he's walking around with his rifle. Preke boy is still in the place because people link me all the time. Sherpy, you know, he's up yesterday me there, so I know said man tell me say Preke boy in the place. Him still gonna drink rum. Him no mix no chase, I'm just drink the rum. That's a Preke boy live. Hard liquor. On the rocks. No chaser. But somehow, every time him go up on a spot, police and get intel, by the time they turn up, Preke boy gone. And in my opinion, one of the things that is keeping Preke boy alive is that he's what you would call the bush type of 87. Meaning you have some 87 who can't sleep a bush. Some of them, if they can't lie down in a feed them bed, or one bed of them know them not comfortable. They must feel somewhere where they can lie down and feel good. Preke boy is happy if you go sleep in a bush for weeks and months, come back, drink some rum, sit up on a corner, go on back into the bush. That's one of the reasons why he's so hard to catch. Right? He's one of the bush type of 87s. Now for the one them, especially the man them come from town or the city, because they're so used to city life and they're so used to, you know, them lie down on a house and roof over them head. As soon as them want it and they, you know, they might go up on the run for 2 weeks. Because of that, they end up going back to them yard, or they going back to them mother yard, they going back to them baby mother yard, and then police just catch them. Preke boy is very happy to live the bush life. And that same bush is what he used to not just evade, but to set up and ambush JDF and JCF. The end, as in how this is going to play out with Preke boy, is going to be very, very interesting. But, well, let's say, live spear, I'll be here to talk about it. Anyway, Patreon squad, big up on yourself, PIA, more life, people, take care of yourself, bless.